Let's be real here, folks. For the most part, snakes don't look that tough. They can't punch you, can't kick you, have pretty limited mobility and a forked tongue. I mean, come on. But nature, in all of its clever evolutionary glory, gave snakes the ultimate chemical compensation, deadly venom. Snake venoms carry a plethora of benefits, for snakes anyways. First, they help snakes both kill and immobilize their prey. Second, some venoms help digest and break down that prey when it becomes a meal. Then, venom acts as a defense mechanism, so if predators are trying to step, they're gonna have to face the consequences, the rather unpleasant consequences. In short, venoms are chemical cocktails of proteins, including special enzymes, all of which are custom-tailored to wreak havoc on different parts of your body. Each component is up to something nasty, and worst of all, the mixtures work well together as a team. Enzymes, as you chemistry buffs already know, help speed up or catalyze chemical reactions. This is why when those fangs get a hold of you, bad things can start happening very quickly. There are four primary categories of snake venoms with varying effects on the body. Hemotoxic venoms can work in a handful of ways. First, these toxins can target red blood cells and blood vessels to cause fatal bleeding. Second, they can activate or inhibit blood clotting in your body. You may have seen this crazy video where this guy injects snake venom into some blood and it turns into a bloody gel biscuit. Well, folks, that is blood clotting in action right there. These venoms have enzymes that speedily convert a blood protein called prothrombin into thrombin. Thrombin then helps another compound called fibrin to start sticking together, which forms clots. What's really crazy though is that some species of snakes have venom so powerful that they use up all of your blood clotting resources to create little microclots. This makes it so real blood stopping clots can't form and you can bleed out. Hemotoxins can also cause hemorrhaging, stroke, and even heart failure. Cytotoxins attack the site of the bite, breaking down the cells and tissue. This venom actually starts digesting the prey. If you're bitten by a snake with cytotoxin, it is possible that you lose that body parts that don't get too attached. Neurotoxins attack your nerves and brain. They can block neurotransmitters from even reaching their appropriate receptors. In other words, they muffle a lot of the important chemical messages that your body uses to regulate its own biological processes. This can also lead to paralysis and even respiratory failure. In other cases, some neurotoxins overload the nervous system, overstimulating receptor cells, ultimately leading to cell death. And some neurotoxins actually break down nerve tissues, just like proteolytic venoms. Proteolytic venoms have enzymes that make the site of a bite undergo proteolysis, which means it breaks down proteins into smaller parts. These nasty enzymes can target cells, blood, and muscles and jumpstart prey digestion, similar to cytotoxins. Proteolytic compounds in venom are the granddaddy of venom agents, with effects similar to the other three classes I just mentioned. All species of venomous snakes contain proteolytic compounds, and good lord do those molecules hurt. As frightening as these venoms are, the majority of venomous snake bites come from situations where people are the ones bothering or mishandling snakes, not the other way around. Out of the average 7,500 annually reported venomous snake bites in the US, only around 5 people actually die each year. They cause more deaths in warmer climates around the world, but snakes still don't really deserve their scary reputation. It also might surprise you to know that scientists look to harness some of these venomous effects for good. A recent example is the discovery that certain snake venoms contain molecules that can help break down amyloid beta proteins, a central cause of the onset of Alzheimer's disease. Also, in 2015, researchers showed that extracted bitroxibin molecules from venom can help clot bleeding wounds within 20 seconds. So you see, folks, snake venoms are a perfect example of how chemistry can work for or against you in a diverse range of ways. What can kill you can also save your life. On the topic of venoms, the animal kingdom has a huge range of weird chemical defenses. We're partial to the hagfish's slime shooting action. Let us know your favorite chemical defense in the comments, and we might explain how it works in future episodes. Make sure to post any chemistry questions in the comments, hit thumbs up, and subscribe on the way out.